And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. Excellent kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game.
Tackle around the 37-yard line. And he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
Pass complete and taken down immediately. Strike to the receiver, and they make the stop around the 45-yard line.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Fumble, loose ball. Using those good hands, he scoops up the fumble. And he is drilled at the 33.
And they will keep the drive alive by recovering their own fumble.
First and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line.
Set. Oklahoma.
He gets out to about the 32-yard line. The halfback picks up a yard.
That brings up second and 9.
Blue 19.
Quick throw, and he's got his receiver again. Tackle made around the 23-yard line. Flares it and almost had it intercepted.
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that.
Here's the eighth play of the series. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. An open field tackle.
Set. Blue 19.
He gets rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Scrambling around. They'll bring him down at the 4-yard line. He scrambles and picks up 5.
That makes us 30.
Mike 40, Mike 40. Down.
And he's level at the 6.
That brings us 4th and goal.
So it's 4th down. They're going to go for the easy 3 here. Washington is looking to go up by 3. He gets it up, and it's through the uprights.
Even though they gave up the field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Michigan State's coaching staff so confident they know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country and that they can just play their game and not worry about the fact they're on the road.
Well, Brett, his big playability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback in this offense just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And I think that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big playability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to be able to execute.
We've got a 2nd and 5. Ball on their own 28.
They got 4 yards on that one.
He took what the defense gave him that time, which is okay. It keeps the yards to go a little bit more manageable.
Tackled at the 42-yard line. First and 10. Ball on their own 42. Nice run there.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and 4.
Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss.
That makes it third and 7.
So we're looking at another third down here. And down he goes at the 43.
First and 10.
Watch a slant. Watch a slant.
Mike 10.
Here we go.
That's a great tackle at the 45.
That is a loss of 2 yards. That'll bring up second and 12.
This is the 8th play of this drive. They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. Pulls in the pass and steps out.
Now they're living on the edge here a little bit, but you know, they're converting when they have to.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Four down.
Mike 10. Dog 4. Green 9.
Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
That's pretty impressive. Accuracy is important, but just as important is having receivers that can make plays.
From the 15-yard line, it's first down. He's on the run, the 10, and he's taken down right around the 6-yard line. After a quarter of play, we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. 3-0, Washington. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play. Off, and he's met immediately. And this is the 13th play of this drive. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
This isn't much more than an extra point. Michigan State is down 3 and looking to tie it up. And they tack on 3 points.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 26. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
Five wide. Now he tries to buy some time, and they got it.
Boy, that time the defense did a really good job of bringing pressure. They brought the blitz, and really it freed up the defensive line to eventually put pressure on the quarterback.
So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack.
Four down. Key eight. Blue 14.
He wants it all going long. Almost picked off.
Number two was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and 12.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime.
It's on the ground, and the ball hawking safety scoops it up, and he's tackled
right around the 46-yard line. That mistake will cost this offense possession of the ball.
And this young safety was right there to pick up the fumble. Huge break for the defense.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
He's on the run.
Makes it to the 37.
That brings up second and one.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Runs it left for a decent game. He's taken down at about the 25-yard line.
No gain on the play. Third down.
40's the mark.
Brought down around the 18-yard line. Delayed handoff, and he's not going to get back to the line.
That brings up second and 13.
It's second and 13. Ball on the 22-yard line. Gets out to about the 21. And they got him.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
Washington could take the lead with this field goal. It's up, looks long enough, and he missed it left. No good.
Every time you have a chance to finish a drive with points, you've got to capitalize. That time, they couldn't come through.
This offense was infected by the turnover bug their last time out. Let's see if they can hold on to the ball here.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
From their own 33-yard line, second down.
Red 2.
Slings it. Tackle right around the 50.
You know, if you use him in this offense the right way, it's almost like you have an extra wide receiver. He's that good.
He's knocked out of bounds
around the 41-yard line.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
Second and one.
Tends the mic. Tends the mic.
Here we go.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. And they make the stop around the 19-yard line.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
The Spartans are going to call their second timeout. And he gets a yard on the run.
When a defense has help and run support from their corners, it takes a lot of pressure off the linebackers and safeties. Great play.
Setting up the play action. Inside the 10. What a play to set them up with a first and goal.
That's a deep 12 on the play.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. They go right back to him, and this time they get him in the backfield. And this is the eighth play of the drive. To his receiver. Tackle made at the 6-yard line.
Kill.
That makes his third and goal.
He's under some heat. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown.
You know, he was looking and looking, and he finally said to himself, you know what? I'll just take this thing myself. Nice decision making.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. A nice 9-play, 68-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive, but the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Across the 30. What a collision.
Well, it's always fun to be part of a defensive battle, and that's certainly what we have right now.
Yeah, give credit to both of these defenses. I mean, they're playing with a lot of energy, and I think they're doing a nice job up front at the line of scrimmage. And at this point, they're not giving either of these offenses a chance to make a play.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
It out to maybe the 36-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of 3. Second down and 7 coming up here. Ball on their own 36.
There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun.
And he tackles him hard at the 44.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Over the middle, got his tight end. They'll bring him down at the 45-yard line. He's tackled at the 32-yard line. Hits him hard at the 18-yard line. They come out in a 5-wide set. And down he goes
around the 11-yard line.
The Huskies using their 3rd and final timeout. So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. Kicks up. And he's got it. excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Both teams wanted to establish a running game. Both teams were stubborn in trying to do so, and neither team was successful. Did you get the sense the defense knew what was coming?
Hey, dude, first and 10 means run. Yeah, I think when you do it every single time, it doesn't really make it hard for a defense to figure out. You can become much more aggressive. You got to take some chances. You want to stick with the run. You want to have that balance. But if you don't push the ball down the field, then I never have to honor it. So mix in some first down passes and runs.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. Going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
Very close game now as we start the second half. From his own goal line, makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. So we're just about ready to return to action. Michigan State holds a four-point lead. And they'll get him in the backfield. And the defensive end comes up with a big play.
Boy, he's quick as a cat, no question. He got tremendous penetration and was able to wrap him up for a loss there.
From their own 18-yard line, second down. They'll drop him for a loss.
This is picture-perfect defense by this corner. Great job of providing run support. Great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. And it seems like they almost save their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game.
So no luck on that drive as they go three and out. Booming kick. Gets to about the 41-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked. The defense really missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it.
From the 41-yard line, it's second down. And he is drilled at the 39. Complete and taken down immediately. So close, but they fall short of the first down.
You got to throw the ball a little deeper next time. Don't take any chances of coming up short.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Gets out to about the 31. Out here. finds his way to the 10-yard line. Just throws this one away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Tailback brought down for a loss.
Loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it third and goal.
It's the ninth play of the drive.
Mike 40, Mike 40.
25, check 25, check 25.
Doubles, doubles. Hey!
Screen, screen.
They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. That's a great tackle at the 11-yard line. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Kicks away, and he got it.
Even though they gave up the field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Washington ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the one. At the 30, he's out of bounds at the 33. You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away. Decided that the call on the field will stand. Michigan State is up one.
Black five, black five.
Throws complete. He's hammered.
Gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Mike 10. Mike 10, Mike 10.
Dog, four.
On the catch, and he steps out.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. First down.
Mike 10 right here, guys. Mike 10.
Red, two.
Green,
go.
15.
And he's taken down around the 46-yard line. From their own 46-yard line. Second down. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. Scrambling, and he can't get away from the pressure. Michigan State with a 1-point lead. Takes it in at the 14. And he's tackled at the 22. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Blue 19. Blue 19.
They'll make the sack. They've been all over this quarterback today.
The pass protection has got to do a better job, but give this defense some credit. They've really figured out what they have to do to pressure the quarterback and to cause him some problems.
looking to dig themselves out of a little hole here after the sack. It's second and 14. Quick pass, and he's tackled at the 25-yard line. Now he's scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. He's taken down around the 44-yard line. Out to around the 48. That's three down and one to go. The Spartans lead it by one. Welcome back to the action. Fourth quarter. This one will decide it. Tight ball game through three. Immediately tackled.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
Brought down at the 26. Screen. Tailback's got it. Tackle at the 25.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That makes it 3rd and 7.
Slings it out there incomplete. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. It's up, and he just drilled it from long range. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Nice run there. Nice gain of around 7 yards on that delay. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Tends the mic. Tends the mic.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
Green nine.
Sends it out quick. Intercepted. He's at the 40. And they make the stop around the 33-yard line. And that is an absolutely huge turnover for this defense. They couldn't have picked that off at a better time.
Just a horrible decision by the quarterback trying to force that pass, especially at this point in the game.
It's first and 10, ball on the 33. Washington with a two-point advantage. He gets rid of this one. With five wide receivers. Now he's flushed and they got it. It was the safety who came from the secondary who made the sack.
Man, this is an aggressive defense. Another blitz, and again, it works out. They send guys from everywhere to get to this quarterback.
Defense hoping for another sack here on third and long.
Watch two, watch two.
Screen, screen.
That's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
He really got a hold of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Lost the ball, fumble, and the defense picks it up.
Once the ball hits the ground, it's a matter of luck and will. And on that play, it was the defensive end who corralled it for his side.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Made around the 2-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Blue 19. Blue 19.
Tries to buy some time, and they got him.
Loss of four on one play.
The Spartans will use their first time out of the half. That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 5-yard line. They come out in a goal line set. The Spartans are going to call their second timeout. Quick strike, and it's caught for the touchdown. Big extra point here. It'll put him up by 2 scores. And he adds the extra point. A 5-play, 10-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. This defensive end has been a force, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, you're right. This guy has just dominated the line of scrimmage today.
You've got to think that one reason they are ahead is because of the boost he's given them. Last time the offense had it, they lost a fumble. So I'm pretty sure the coaching staff was over there talking about ball security.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw.
That makes it second and two.
Spikes the ball.
That'll bring up third and two.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Just under 2 minutes in the game. He gets sacked on the play.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page, and they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. He airs it out. Almost intercepted there.
Number 13, the intended receiver.
From the 35-yard line, it's second down. Here they come. Steps up in the pocket. And down he goes at the 8-yard line.
Excellent execution on one side of the ball that time. And it looks to me like the defense was in a little state of confusion. Let's see if they can pull themselves together.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
Four down. Tens the mic. Tens the mic.
Back five.
There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
False start. Offense.
That penalty will move him back a bit.
Yeah, and with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
Tight end right. Tight end right. Four down. Mike 10.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
On the throw, incomplete pass. He caught it, but failed to get that one necessary foot in.
That's an outstanding catch, and he just missed making a big-time play.
From the 13-yard line. It's third down, a little over a minute in the game. Under heavy pressure, quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
The ball was underthrown. It was a good read. He just needs to find his rhythm back there and step and throw the football.
You can talk about offense all you want, and they were good today, but the defense was better. They come up with a play of the day, and that'll lead to the victory. They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He's tackled at the 29-yard line. Just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock.
Oklahoma,
and he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. Michigan State staff and really this entire team, I'm sure, is going to rally around this kid.
Yeah, it's a tough loss for this team. I mean, they put so much into this game. But one thing about them is they're a team. And even though their star player had a tough game, I think they'll pick him back up and get him ready to go by next week.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.